Good morning, dear students.
Today we will start the next point. See, this last point it was remaining in this lesson, and the lesson name is materials, metals, and non-metals. Okay. So, in this materials, metals, and non-metals, before we discuss about many points, that is physical and chemical properties of metals and non-metals, and last lecture we have discussed about the displacement reaction. Okay, so today we will start the last point, that is the uses of metals and non-metals. So first we will see uses of metals. See here, I written some metals and the use of that metals. Okay, after this lecture you just write down in your notebook this, and see here only some examples I given what is the use of that metal, but you have to write the most of the metals and their uses. Okay, so the first metal mostly common, that is a copper. See, copper, what is a see, in physical properties we learn what are the physical properties of the copper. See, copper, it is a good conductor of electricity. Okay, so mostly it is used in this electrical wires. So copper, it is used in making electrical wires. It is the major use of copper. See, mostly which is a good conductor of electricity, best conductor of electricity, that is a silver, but mostly commonly we are using copper. Okay, so this is the main use of copper. Now see the second one, it is used to make utensils. Now utensils, you all are know that. Okay, it is used to make utensils. Now what, see, plastics also one substance, but we are not using the plastics to make the utensils. Means, okay, some are there plastic box, plastic containers that we are using, but see, these metals, they are having the characteristic to take, means, good conductor of heat, and because of that the copper is used to make utensils. Okay, now see the third use, used for making alloys that are used in making coins and pipes. Now alloys means what? Here is a mixture of more than one metal. Okay, so the copper, they are making the copper and they make the different things. Okay, so what are that things? See here, coins, which one regularly we are using, that coins. So it is a alloy of copper and pipes. Okay, pipes is also made up of the alloy of copper. Now the second metal we will see, that is iron. See, iron is also most important. Most of the things in your surrounding, see, just you observe your room, you will get the many things which is made up of the iron. Now here see this grill, that is also made up of iron. Why? Because of that the physical properties. Why? It is it is very hard. Iron is very hard, and because of that we are using to make grills. Okay, then door, safety door, that is also made up of iron. So many things we can make by iron. So here it is, some uses are given, that is make pipe, storage tanks, cylinders. Okay, these are the common use of iron. You write more uses also. Here only just the two or three uses I written, but you write more points. Now see, stainless steel, an alloy of iron. Now stainless steel, see, mostly utensils we are using, that is a metal of a stainless steel. Then stainless steel is not one separate metal. Okay, that stainless steel is alloy of iron. See here, stainless steel, it is here in bracket, an alloy of iron, and it is used to make utensils. Means daily, whichever the utensils at home you are using, that mostly made up of a stainless steel, and the stainless steel is an alloy of iron. Okay, now see the next, that is the most common, and you know everyone what is the use of that. That is a gold and silver, most common use to make jewelry. See, if any functions, and because that functions we are wearing the jewelry. So mostly common use of gold and silver used to make jewelry, and it is more malleable and ductile. The physical properties we already learned before. Okay, and because of that physical property, it is used to make jewelry here and decorative items. Okay, so this gold and silver used to make jewelry and decorative items. See, the next it is a platinum. See, platinum also used to make jewelry, but it is more costly than gold and silver. Okay, this platinum used to making jewelry. It is also used to make jewelry only, but it is more costly than a gold and silver. Okay, that because of the same properties, this platinum is also used. Then now see the zinc. Zinc is used in a dry cells. Now dry cells means whenever it is battery. The cell dry cell, you know, in 6th standard also we have learned about that, the cell structure and all. So in dry cell that zinc one rod is there. So zinc is used in a dry cell as well as in a galvanization process. Now galvanization means what? To prevent the rust. Okay, iron, you know, iron mostly it is rusting of iron, we learn. And in that, in 6th standard physical and chemical change, in that lesson we learn about the galvanization. Galvanization is a coating of zinc. Zinc metals, they are giving the coating on iron, any material, iron, any substance, and because of the galvanization process they can prevent from rusting. Okay, so here are the some metals and their uses. So first one, copper. Just remember where it is used, write 2 and 3 uses of each metal. Each means mostly common metals whichever we are using regularly. Okay, so here I given the 5 metals and examples. So these all examples you write down in your notebook. Okay, now next point we will learn, that is the uses of non-metal. Okay, now next point we will learn, that is the uses of non-metal. See some examples, some non-metals, for 2 or 3 non-metals we will see, and what are the uses of that. Okay, these are the very simple point, that is the uses of metals and non-metals. So already we discussed about the uses of metals, now we will see uses of non-metals. Now see here, the first non-metal is carbon. Carbon, see carbon in each substance, most of the common, whatever the substance are present here, that carbon is present. See, in higher classes, maybe in 10th, 11th, 12th, there is a one separate lesson, that is a carbon and carbon compound. So that time you will understand what is exactly carbon. Okay, so what are the uses of carbon? See, carbon in the form of graphite. See, carbon means if you will ask this is a carbon, no, carbon it is in the form of, means carbon is present in form. Okay, so in this graphite, see here, graphite, carbon in the form of graphite. Now graphite, everyone know, in the form of graphite it is used in electrodes in a dry cells. Okay, graphite in the form of carbon, it is used in electrodes in a dry cells because it is good conductor of electricity. See here, mostly all metals are good conductor of electricity. Okay, but graphite, you know, it is exceptional. It is exceptional, means it is a non-metal, but even though it has a capacity to conduct the electricity. Okay, it is an exceptional case, non-metals. Mostly all non-metals are not good conductor of electricity. They are the bad conductor of heat and electricity. But exceptional case is a graphite. Okay, so carbon in the form of graphite is used in electrodes, in dry cells, because it is good conductor of electricity. Okay, now see the next one is iodine, iodide salt. Every day we are eating, then we know that if the lack of iodine, which this is the cause. So this iodine, it is used for preparing iodized salt. Okay, where it is used iodine, it is used for preparing iodized salt. Means in everyday salt you are using, in that iodine is present. Okay, the next one, it is oxygen. Now oxygen, it's very important. Oxygen is used for the respiration process. Means human beings, mostly all the living things need oxygen for the respiration process. See, without oxygen we can't live, so it is the most use of oxygen. Then nitrogen, see, atmospheric nitrogen we are not using directly. Then that nitrogen fixation and all points already we discussed before. Okay, so nitrogen is used in manufacturing fertilizers. So which one it is used? Nitrogen is used in manufacturing fertilizers. Okay, the next is chlorine. It is used for the disinfecting water and manufacturing bleaching powder. Now chlorine, see, chlorine water. Okay, chlorine water mostly in the villages they provide in chlorine water in the rainy season. Why? Because the chlorine is used to make the disinfecting water is what? It kills germs. So chlorine water is used, and see, chlorine tablets also available. That tablets also we can use for this, and it used to manufacture bleaching powder. So these are some common uses of non-metals. Here only 5 examples I given you. If you will give any information related to this point, means uses of metals and non-metals, write down in your chemistry notebook. Okay, maybe any more example, just here 5 examples of metals and 5 examples of non-metals, and what are the uses that we discuss now. So today this lesson is completed. Which lesson is completed? Materials, metals and non-metals. In this one practical is remaining, that we will see afterwards. Okay, what it is, the one activity is given in your textbook, that displacement reaction related to that one practical is remaining, that we will see afterwards. Okay, so today this lesson is completed. So next period onwards we will start our next lesson. Okay, before to start next lesson, if you have doubts regarding any points in this lesson, just contact me or forward one message. Okay, so first we will clear all the doubts if you have related to this topic, and then we will continue the next lesson. Okay, so thank you.